Okay, this is take two, and a warm welcome to my latest let's play of Train Sim World 2. And our attraction today is the Caltrain EMD F40PH. Unit number is 913, and without further ado, let's head towards the engineer's cab and let's get started. Hopefully, fingers crossed, this one will turn out better than the last attempt did. An absolute disaster. So, run into the cab and get the train ready for service. Make sure to close the door. And we'll just take a seat in the cab. The engineer's chair as well. Next task is to release the doors. We'll just do that now. Just thought I'd do the thumbnail, as then I can just concentrate on the tracks ahead without worrying about the external views and stuff. I will say this, I do find this train is quite buggy, so you have to be careful with the brakes, because for whatever reason, if you accidentally put the brakes into emergency, they will not release. Well, at least that's what I found out in the last attempt. Okay, all the passengers are aboard, doors are secure, so it's just a matter of getting the train ready to go and just following the prompts on the screen and stuff. So, just using notch 2 just to get us away, as I don't overload the traction motors, and hopefully this one should turn out better. So I'm just waiting for the brakes to fully release. Without further ado, just doing a quick pulse on the horn there. We've got about 4 minutes to get ourselves to San Mateo, that is 6:11 on this duty. And we are now approaching, well, just gone past 30 miles an hour, so I'm going to go full power just to get our speed up, and I will start slowing down at about 1.2 miles to go, as I'm not sure what the strength of the brakes are on this train, and I definitely do not want to miss the station if I can possibly help it. We are coming up to the maximum permitted speed limit, so I'm just leveling off the power, folks, and I will use the brakes at about 1.2. So I want a medium strength, so we bring it down nice and gradually, not too harsh on for the passengers. So just placing that into service, and we'll just leave it there until we get the train to a nice steady speed. Although we are losing speed quite rapidly, so I'm just going to put that back into lap because I'm not used to these brakes. I'm just going to release that so we don't lose too much speed. But we are about just an eighth of a mile now till we reach the San Meteo, and we are about half a minute late, but I'm not too fussed about that, folks. As you know, I've not used this train in a very long time, as I've mostly been automatically allocated the MP36PH, which is a lot easier to drive than this one. So, in all honesty, I do like a challenge, so I'm going to get this one done. Fingers crossed, I can hopefully release the brakes once we reach this station, as I did get stuck on the first attempt, which was a bit unfortunate. Okay, what I'm going to do, because this train is buggy and them timings are just way too tight for this train, as the brakes are very buggy on this, I have to put it into service to put the brakes on, and I have to move it back to lap to hold the pressure, then I have to release and then apply again. So this is definitely a different driving technique to the other trains. So I will need some more practice for this, but I'm going to carry on and just show this train off in its full glory, as I really do like the EMD F40PHs. And maybe someday I can get a model of this Caltrain one, but that's for another video. Anyways, just waiting for the passengers to finish boarding and alighting, and then we can lock the doors and then head on to our next station stop, which will be, we'll find out in a minute anyways, but just waiting for these doors to finish closing, and our next station stop will be Hillsdale. just did a tiny pulse on the horn there, just to provoke the bell to come on as we are going over a crossing. So I'm just going to do a long tone over this level crossing. I realise it's not the correct American Railroad procedure, but I'm not a professional engineer at all. I'm not even a real train driver, but respect to those of you who are. I do these Let's Plays just for fun, and I really just enjoy exploring these trains across these routes. Anyways, we've got another crossing coming up, but I'm just going to make sure that everyone can hear me and no cars and stuff will just go in front of me. Anyways, that's the crossing to start with. Time to increase our power now. I'm trying not to lose too much time, but I can't make any promises. I'm going to carry on to the end anyways. I'm going to try and avoid overdoing the brakes, as I definitely don't want to stall the train. As for whatever reason, there is a bug that once the brakes come on into emergency mode, you can't release them and you can't take power either. I know I'm about 5 minutes late, folks, but I really don't care. I'm just carrying on as normal, as these timing points are way too tight for this train, in my experience. And to be honest, I just do these for fun. But as the saying goes, better late than never.
doors are about to close.
I will say this one, this train is much harder to drive and handle, and it handles very differently to the MP36PH, but I don't mind that at all. I do love a challenge, to be honest with you folks, and I really am enjoying this one. And I do hope that Dovetail Games will do the Miami to West Palm Beach for Train Sim World 2 in the future, as I really do like Florida, and I'll definitely will cover that route as and when it's done, as I think that would be a nice addition to Train Sim World 2, in my opinion. Okay folks, I'm going to start braking now, so just moving down to the lap position, and we need to get that red needle to around 25, definitely below 30, so we do not slow down too early. So I'm hoping to try and get used to the brakes and get a feel for how they work, as they definitely are not as responsive at first, unlike the MP36PH, but all of a sudden they just really come on hard, So I'm just gonna get used to that, you know. But anyways, all being well, we should be able to pull into this station nice and smoothly. Just coming in at 30 miles an hour there, folks. So if I need to, I will put some more brake force on, but so far so good. We are slowing down gradually, so that's grand. And I think the stopping distance will be a lot better in terms of the position, as we're almost fully into the green spot there, or at least half of the locomotive base. So just cancel that bell, release the doors, and get these passengers on. We are 5 minutes late, folks, but I'm not too fussed about that. As to be honest, this train is a lot different to what I'm used to with the MP36PH. As for some reason, when I do load this route up, it picks that train automatically instead of this one. And I'd prefer it if I had a choice at the menu rather than just being thrown in to a random train. As you know, I do enjoy this one, and I do plan to do many more Let's Plays of Train Sim World 2. But I do intend to continue doing Train Simulator Classic, but as more add-ons come out of American trains and stuff, as I do like the American trains, to be honest with you folks, I will do more of those in Train Sim World 2. Right, folks, time to lock the doors, and without further ado, once that is done, we can then proceed onwards to Redwood City. That will be our next station stop, and we definitely will not make that time. We will be about 5 minutes late, so I'm going to try and pull away in notch 4 without causing too much, if any, discomfort to the passengers. So trying to keep the delays to a minimum here, as we are 3 minutes late already, and it will be about 5 maybe 6 minutes late by the time we get to Redwood City. So far what I'm doing, I'm getting used to the brakes now, so the red needle on the brake gauge just to the left of the screen, ideally, you don't want that any higher than 25 when you are beginning to slow down. I mean, I've got a caution signal there, folks, so we may be following a train up ahead, so I'm not really sure why that is, as we are late, so not sure what's up with the signals there, but as I was saying about the brakes, I'm going to start applying the brakes at about 900 to 800 yards, as then I don't have to, well, hopefully won't miss or overrun the platform. And we are 5 minutes late already, and we still have 1.5 miles to go. Okay, we've got a red signal coming up, folks, so I think this could be the last of the stations. And I'm happy with the score. I'm not really bothered if I get gold or not, as this is my first attempt with this locomotive, so better ease off that brake there, as we're going a bit too slow now. But we're running about 6 or 7 minutes late, but I'm not too bothered, as the timing points, considering this is my first go in the F40PH outside the tutorials, and I haven't covered this train for a while, so I'm not going to be too hard on myself, and if I really want that gold, I'll just do it again once I'm getting used to the brakes and stuff. Anyways, better turn on the bell, and we're just coming into Redwood City, and that will be our finishing point for this scenario and this let's play, I think, as far as I know. And I just want to say to you, if you stayed with me through to the end of the video, big thank you for watching. Please do feel free to post your comments and stuff, as I do read your comments and that. But anyway, folks, till next time, take care of yourselves and each other. All the best, God bless, and I'll catch you in the next one. That's all for now, folks. I'll see you in the next one.